The Ford Mustang is the longest continued production Ford of all time, which means it must be one successful pony car. The Mustang is known for its V8 power plant, great looks and awesome sound. To give you an idea of exactly how successful the Mustang was, it had record-breaking sales and it led to many other legendary cars being produced, like the Camaro, Firebird and Challenger. But is the Mustang any good or is it just overrated? But before we get into it, remember to like and subscribe, and if you enjoy this type of content, I have many more videos just like this linked in the description, and I've got more content on my channel. Please go check it after the video. Enough plugging, let's get into it. Sorry, I have to do it. If you have around 35k to spend on a sports car, I don't think there's anything else you can buy that can provide you with a roaring rear-wheel drive V8 that can do things like this. And this. And even this. The Mustang is a really well-priced all-round sports car, except for fuel economy, but that's unimportant, we don't care about that. The new Mustang has a crazy 10-speed gearbox with seriously fast shifts, and unlike BMW and other companies, the box is Ford built, not bought from another company. The Mustang produces 416 brake horsepower from factory, and 0 to 62 is reached in 4.8 seconds, which is really not bad for a car of this price. I'm guessing you can hear, I kinda like the Mustang. But in my defense, what other car can you buy with close to 500 horsepower for 35-ish K? Obviously options will raise the price, but even a fully spec'd one you can get for under 50K. And that's new off the lot. And these cars get brownie points because it's part of a dying breed of cars. You see, manufacturers aren't allowed to make big, loud, uneconomical cars anymore. Unfortunately, the days are numbered for cars like the Mustang, the Challenger, and even the big V8 Mercs. This makes me quite sad, because big V8 muscle cars always put a smile in anybody's face. Except of course your Karens, but it will put a smile in anything from kids to fully grown adults. So what is the bad, if there is any? It's a two-seater, sold as a four-seater. The rear seats aren't really meant for sitting on. It's more for decoration purposes. And the interior in general feels a bit cheap, especially if you are coming from something like an Audi or BMW. The doors are really big and heavy, so tight parking spots are quite a nightmare, and the last problem for me is the fact that they are common, like really common. I like cars that you don't see every day, and because the Mustang is such a great deal, you see them quite a lot. If I'm completely honest, the car has way more pros than cons, and the cons aren't too serious. I might have ignored the fact that they tend to leak oil, but that's not serious either. For the money, it's an awesome sports car with a lot of power, and I guarantee you, you will fall in love with the car in between the fuel stops. Just do something to set yours apart from the rest. Maybe a sporty kit or mags or a really big supercharger. So at the end of the day, I think this car is freaking letty. It's definitely not shitty. hope you guys enjoyed. If you have got a different opinion than me, leave a comment, leave a like. Check you guys in the next one. Cheers, aye.